body language, the way you are using, but some of the
by birth. C.T.M. Hisham Jaffry, a talented, humble, down to the earth person who loves to help others by all means. He is for me, and I'm sure he is for others also, a devoted brother, peer, friend, and a positive character that can jump into your mind and doing any role. D.T.M. Hisham loves figures, numbers, because he is a finance man. Besides, teaching is his charming role as well. That's why he is in the education provision. He also enjoys being number one, by the way. And that's why he is a winner at any club, area, and division contest. I know when DTM, he's always trying to challenge him. And I think DTM Hisham, he will say, who is he during his speech? Even during the tabletop contest, he will bring him and he will say it, he will talk about it. Please welcome our beloved, charming, handsome, and unique DTM Hisham Jaffry in his workshop, taking terror out of table topics.
Thank you very much, Mr. T.M. Odia and Mr. Vice President Education, for that wonderful and warm introduction on this chilly evening. It is always such a great pleasure to come and to come back to Bahrain IT Professionals Toastmasters Club. I mean, everyone says parenting and fatherhood is a great responsibility, but what they don't say is it is also a great pleasure. And to see this tiny seed to have grown into such a mighty oak in Bahrain within the short span of 3 years gives me a tremendous amount of pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for table topics. I want you to do one thing. I want you to unmute your microphone and say, good evening, welcome to Bahrain IT Professionals. Do that now.
Good evening and welcome to Bahrain IT Toastmasters Club.
Thank you very much, everyone, for that nice, warm welcome. So now you have got your vocal cords loosened. And as with the theme of our workshop, we will have some time for us to loosen our vocal cords even more. So I hope you're ready. Let's get on with the interesting stuff. Let me share my screen with you. The purpose of our workshop today is to take the terror out of table topics. Now you can ask the question, why? One person that I really admire, who might be a negative influence on the world, but there are certain things that he says that are really, really important. And one such important quote was this. Everybody has a plan until they get punched in the face. Then, like a rat, they stop in fear and freeze. Table topics is just like this. Now, the person who made this quote is none other than the former heavyweight champion of the world, undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Mike Tyson. Table topics is like this, punch in the face. Because when you take table topics, it's something that you have no idea what it's going to be. Yet voluntarily, you are standing here in order to answer this particular topic. But you can still ask the question, how on earth does it relate to me? I have planned my life. I have prepared myself so well. There is nothing that can actually surprise me. I want to share with you a few examples from my personal life. You may not have been in a boxing match. You may not have been hit with physical punches. But definitely, these verbal punches can come at you in so many different situations. It is our duty to be able to shine through these punches and win that championship. So over the next couple of minutes, we want to see what are the tips, tricks, hacks, shortcuts, secret sources that we can learn in order to master table topics with a smile. So the first example that I want to share with you is this. Have you ever been asked this question? You are at an interview and the interviewer asks you, Where do you see yourself in 5 years' time? We Google these questions. We might know this question is going to be asked. But when it is asked, it's like a punch in the face and we might freeze in fear. It's December. It's year-end appraisal time. Your appraiser, your boss, sitting along with the HR, can ask you or can tell you, we are not promoting you. We are not giving you an extra salary. But what we are giving you is some extra responsibility. How will you respond? Table topics can prepare you for it. You are at Lulu Hypermarket and someone asks you, excuse me, are the cabbages on discount today? They assume that you are working in their Lulu simply because you are wearing a tie. How will you respond? You are at Sharaf DG and someone asks you, are you selling the iPhone at a reasonable price or shall I go and pay cash and buy it at GR? How will you respond? Finally, you are daydreaming at a conference and suddenly the presenter asks you, how do you think we can solve this particular issue? What do you think? All of these happened to me over the last 15 years. So table topics can help you to prepare you to answer these sort of questions. Now, why is it important? Because you get a few seconds to make an impression. You get 8 seconds to make your first impression, and those impressions last. That is why we are here on a Monday evening trying to understand this beautiful art of trying to speak off the cuff, impromptu, to make that impression that takes you to the minds, the hearts, and the brains of those that come into contact with you. Let's take this word impromptu. What does impromptu mean? So I want to share with you two definitions. The first one, I don't agree with. The second one, I agree with. Let's look at the first one. Impromptu means it is done without rehearsing. Now it is true, but I don't agree with it. Why? Because if you're in the business of speaking, if you're in the business of teaching, if you're in the business of coaching, mentoring, leading, communicating, running a business, employing people, working at a bank, washing a car, working at McDonald's, it doesn't matter. At every point, you're selling yourself. At every point, you're making an impression. You've got to be able to have this down to an art. So at any point, the impression that you make should be very well rehearsed, and you should know with crystal clear clarity what it is that you want to present, project, communicate to the outside world. And that's why I disagree with this word impromptu. You've got to be ready to make that impression at any point, at any stage, under any spotlight. The second meaning I agree with. The word impromptu comes from the Latin word and it means to be in readiness. Because you never know when opportunity will knock. When opportunity knocks, you don't answer the door. You break down the door, you carry the house and you take it away with you. Because in this world of almost 8 billion people, if you don't open the door, then that opportunity is just going to fly away. And the words that you utter, the ideas that you construct, conveyed properly, will give you that once in a lifetime opportunity. So that's the importance of table topics. And that's why it is such a critical cornerstone of this program called Toastmasters that we know and love. So the model that I always use, and this is the single model that I always use for table topics, it has served me faithfully and very well. As a matter of fact, a couple of years ago, I even used it to get out of a traffic ticket when I took an illegal U-turn at the Jufed Junction near California Green. It has very real practical applications. So what does this PREP model mean? It's an acronym for 4 actions. Let's apply it. So what does PREP mean? Position. Position simply means where do you stand? What is your opinion? What's your idea? What do you feel? What do you think? Remember, your position is like your nose. Everybody has a nose and they are entitled to it. Everybody has a position and you are entitled to your position. So before you answer the table topics question, ask yourself, what do I feel about this? Is it good or bad, high or low, favorable or unfavorable, controllable or uncontrollable, internal or external, agree or disagree? That's step number one. Step number two, why do you feel that way? So for example, I can ask you, are you a winter person or are you a summer person? You can be a winter person, you can be a summer person. There is no right or wrong about it. But there'll always be a reason for it. I asked this question from one of my students, are you a winter person or a summer person? And she said, I am 100% a winter person. I asked her, what is the reason and why? And she said, because that is the time where Starbucks comes out with its two famous coffees. And that tells me, or that gives me that real feeling of joy. So that's the reason why she likes winter. Whether it's right or wrong, up for debate. But that's the reason you feel the way you do. Number three, give us an example. The last winter that I sat down in Starbucks and I had that coffee, my worries were taken off like cotton candy on the wind and it flew away. What do you feel? Why do you feel that way? Give me an example that proves to me that you really feel this way. And then finally, because your last words linger and your last thoughts tantalize, you must repeat your position. So this is the prep model. This is the only model that I will use, that I have used. And this is a model that I can safely vouch for in Table Topics at the club, in the Table Topics contest, on the stage, and on the real world life stage. This model serves you tremendously well. And I want to give credit to the person who taught me this model. At a workshop that was done about 4 years ago, a gentleman called Distinguished Toastmaster Anil Menon taught this model. And this was the first model that he discussed. And that has stuck in my mind all these years through. Now, what are the details, or how can we go into a little bit more nitty gritty into this model? So when you say position, it could be you either agree or disagree. For example, a couple of days ago, we had a debate where we said public speaking should be a compulsory part of university education. You might agree, you might disagree. That's your position. Or it could be, my opinion is, my thinking is, my feeling on this topic is. Remember, you think what you think, you feel what you feel, you hear what you hear, and what's inside you is what's inside you. There is no right or wrong. It is your emotion or it is your thought. But how you articulate and present it is what's really crucial. The reason you feel that way, this is because. I say this as a result of what influenced me to think this way. And this is your preamble, or this is your introduction to the example or the story that is to follow. And when you go to that example, as we all know and love, a personal story is the best example. It may be a quotation, it may be a story, it may be an incident, it may relate to emotion, it may relate to humor. But if you can give an example, that solidifies and cements the validity of your commentary. When I was 6 years old, Abraham Lincoln once said, in the December issue of The Economist magazine, once when I was working in audit, one of my managers said, if you don't have evidence, it does not exist. Now, Table Topics is not as harsh as that. But in a contest, if you have evidence and someone else has emotion, if you have evidence and someone else has words, you have something that nobody else has, then you will get something that nobody else gets. So be ready with a story. See how you can give additional evidence to your emotion and thoughts by solidifying and cementing it with the base of that story. And then finally, come back and repeat your position, because that's the thought that will remain in the minds of your audience. How do you know a car is good to drive? This is your opportunity. You can unmute and tell me, how do you know that a car is good to drive?
when I start and it is going.
When you start and when it is going.
Start the ignition. To start the engine.
Start the ignition. Great. So, generally, you have to get into the car, take her for a test drive. So, you've got the theory. Let's now rev it up and take it for a spin. I hope you're ready. Let's do it. So, our topic is, and I hope you're ready, because I want your mental juices to start flowing and those microns and electrons and neutrons and protons to start firing. Your topic is very complicated topic. Do you like to eat chocolate or apples? Do you like to eat chocolate or apples? I'll give you 3 seconds to think about it. That's one. That's two. That's three. Let's apply the prep model. Let's apply the prep model. So what is your position? Do you agree or disagree? Do you like apples or do you like chocolates? Right now, you would have an image. It could be a Mars bar or a Snicker bar. It could be a red apple or green apple. You feel what you feel. You see what you see. You smell what you smell. Now ask yourself, why do I feel that way? What is the reason? What pushed me to feel that way? Why is it that I like chocolate? Oh, I hate chocolate. Why is it that I love apple? Oh, I absolutely loathe apple. I don't like to see apples at all. Why? And then an example. And the example could be, the last time I ate chocolate, I got the worst allergic reaction in the world. Or the last time I ate chocolate, I was so stressed and that first bite made me feel like I had taken a first class express ticket straight to heaven. Why do you feel the way you do? What is the example that proves your thought or your emotion? And then finally, and this is why I tell you that I cannot live in a world where there is chocolate. Or you say, this is why I tell you, if there is no apple, I am not going to live in this world. Position, reason, example, and your position. Simple model, effective model, useful model, practically applicable on the stage, in the club, out there in the real world. Now, it's unlikely that on the contest stage that you would get a topic that is so beautiful and relates to apples and chocolates. So let's kick it up a notch. Let's make it a little bit more serious. I hope you're ready. Topic number two, on the way. Get your table topics hat on. Get the thinking hat on. Because if you do what everyone does, you will get what everyone gets. So try to twist, try to dig up something unique. The greatest companies in this world make the greatest profit because they give something that no one else can do. To make the biggest profit, you must solve the biggest problems. So twist, think differently, a different angle, a different element to your commentary. Now, how do you do that? Be unique. Be creative. Be different. Make this a habit whenever you open your mouth to speak. Now, our topic spoke about apples and chocolates. How do you get creative? I think Toastmaster Mohammed is trying to punch me from the screen. I should get onto this side a little bit. So, let's see. So you say, you know what? I don't like apple. I don't like chocolate. But when you combine it together, I get chocolate covered apples. Add a little bit of cashew. Add a little bit of chocolate. Add a little bit of chocolate sauce. And man, you got me talking. Be unique. Be memorable. Because this picture that I show you now is probably something that you will remember. You will forget my face. You will forget everything else. But somewhere down the line, you might remember chocolate-covered apples because it is unique. You are unique, and your table topic commentary should follow that same thread of being unique, being special, being one in a million. And that's how you become memorable. Sample topic number two. On to a little bit more of the serious business. I hope you're ready. Here it comes. Whether you think you can or whether you think you can't, you are right. whether you think you can or whether you think you can't. You are right. So I'll give you 5 seconds to think it over. That's one. That's two. That's three. That's four. And that's five. Let's apply the PREP model. So what's your position? Do you agree or disagree? Do you feel this is right or wrong? Do you feel this is absolute brilliance or complete stupidity? What is your position on it? That's number one. Why do you feel that way? Is it personal experience? Is it a tragedy? Is it a quote? Is it a book? Why do you feel that way? And then can you give us proof, evidence? What is your concrete evidence to support your commentary? And then finally, your position. And then finally, your position. I agree or disagree because of this. For me personally, it is a quote that I agree with. Because physical strength can be replaced. It can be substituted by so many things. But the mental and moral strength that you have will manifest itself outwards in everything you do. Because beliefs impact your decisions, and decisions convert into actions, and those actions leave lasting monuments for a lifetime. So it's not outside in, it's inside out. What is in here will get built out there. So whether you think you can or you can't, that is the ignition that we were speaking about to start that car to take you on a world conquering journey. And that's personally how I feel about that topic, that quote, and that's something, a quote that I really like. So don't think that I will be commenting in all of the topics myself. I hope that you are loosening your vocal cords. Let's do this. A famous person once made this quote: "It usually takes me more than 3 weeks to prepare a good impromptu speech." And this person is none other than Mark Twain, the famous American humorist, novelist, journalist, and lecturer. This next quote is a quote that I really, really like, and I really, really believe in. And the quote goes a little bit like this: "Don't get ready to speak. Stay ready to speak." Because you never know when the opportunity will arise. And the person who made this quote is none other than the 1999 world champion of public speaking, Craig Valentine. Widely known as one of the more popular world champions, he's built a very successful public speaking business. And this is a quote. He says that when I landed in Baltimore, after I won the world championship, right, someone came up to me and said, "To the world champion, say something." And he says, "That's when I realized that I can't get ready to speak. I have to be ready to speak at any given opportunity." As a speaker, leader, communicator, trainer, teacher, mentor, coach, educator, you've got to be ready with your ideas to just put them out in the correct structure, in the correct way, where it makes the best punching impact. You can either punch or get punched. The choice is up to you. There's another, and this is the final quote that I will share with you. And it goes a little bit like this: "You may not have the answer to every question, but you definitely, definitely, 100% for sure have an answer to every question." And that quote is from me. You may not be able to answer every question, but you may not have the correct answer, but you will have your own unique answer. So make sure that you are able to put across that idea, because people don't ask you for the textbook. They ask you for the, "How can you make my pain go away?" That's what makes you unique. Because everybody in this world can fry Kentucky Fried Chicken. Why does Colonel Sanders make more money? Because he's able to do it, or actually say he does it, in a different way. Coca-Cola is sugar and water. But the way they say it and place it and position it and market it is why it becomes so, so recognizable. Impromptu speaking is a skill. Now, how do you build a skill? Repeat, sleep, get up, repeat, sleep, get up, repeat. Repetition is the mother of all skill. So practice. Impromptu speaking is a mindset. The words are the output. The input comes from here and it comes from here. What you say should be what you believe and what you think and what you feel. The words are the manifestation of what's in here. So make sure that you nourish yourself here, here, so that what comes out here is of 100% quality and 18 karat gold weight. Impromptu speaking is an attitude. You should believe in what you say and you should believe in the value of your thoughts. If you don't believe in your product, how will you convince somebody else that your product is good? So know yourself, reflect, have that concrete thoughts within you. So whenever you are given the platform, you are ready to set fire to the stage, whether it is virtual or whether it is physical. Now it's time for some brave volunteers. And by volunteers, I mean, I will pick some volunteers. So what we will do is we have time for four table topics. I'll share with you a table topic. We will have a minute or two, Mr. Timer. I hope you are awake and have injected coffee into your system, because now you will have four different sets of timing. 1 to 2 minutes. At 1 minute, the green light. 1.5 minutes, the amber light. 2 minutes, we will have the red light. 1 minute, green. 1.5 minute, amber. 2 minutes, the red light. Our first brave volunteer will be, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome contestant number one, someone who is very, very familiar to us, Toastmaster Manjula Nagendra. Toastmaster Manjula, if you will, loosen up your vocal cords and let us see you. I hope we have not scared her away. Toastmaster Manjula, you're here.
Toastmaster Manjula.
No, Toastmaster Manjula is not there.
Oh, that is unfortunate. So then we will have to move on to victim number two. Toastmaster Maria Praveen. Please tell me we have not scared you away. Toastmaster Maria, are you still with us? Zoom should have a function where we can unveil all the cameras too.
No, she's also not there.
Toastmaster Maria is missing as well. Toastmaster Dinesh Kumar, let's give it to the guys. Toastmaster Dinesh, are you with us?
Yes.
Fabulous. Thank you so much. So take a deep breath. If you are ready, your topic is money is the root of all evil. Money is the root of all evil. Toastmaster Dinesh Kumar.
Thank you, Table Topic Master, other fellow Toastmasters and honored guests. Money is the evil root of the all evil. I fully agree. People get much influenced by the alcohol than get more influenced by the money. We can see the many example of the great emperor, the king, due to the influence of the money, they are moving, or we can say the getting down from their moral. When we come to it, the normal person, until we don't have the money, we will run behind the money to earn the money. When it will be more than our the routine or with the minimum requirement, then people will try to move the girl, the luxurious. It will start by purchasing a high block or the flat or the cars. And then some more, they will indulge illegal activity due to the influence of the money. Money, people should be in control. what is the minimum need. More than that, if you have the money, sure, our this human nature, mind will go to the other way. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Ram, for saving me and taking that topic as well. I was afraid that I might have to start committing on it. So you use the PEP model. Let's debrief. So you did use the PEP model. You very clearly said, I fully agree. You didn't say agree. I said, I fully agree. And then you give us reasons. You came and you transitioned into alcohol and you said that this is what's happening to the external world, which was very nicely done. And there was a fairly smooth transition as well. Maybe there was not enough time for a personal story or a quotation, or that was not solid enough in the presentation, which is something that all of us can improve. And then your summary, your last words linger. You did give us a somewhat strong summation. What did you do well? You were 100% sincere and you were convinced. And I felt that when you came to the stage, you had something you wanted to say. You had a very specific example. You didn't say stuff things. You said alcohol and you said money. I like that about it. What could you do better? While you're constructing the speech within the first 30 seconds, go a little bit slow so that you can think of a story to bring in the body of the speech. Is this easy to do? No. It takes a little bit of practice. If everyone can do it, everyone will be able to do it. So it takes a little bit of practice. Thank you for being speaker number one. Let's move on to the next speaker. Do we have Toastmaster Ram in the house? Toastmaster Ram Tamang?
No.
Toastmaster Ram is not there. Then do we have Toastmaster Esther Green? Do we have Toastmaster Esther in the house?
Ram Tamang is there.
Toastmaster Ram, would you like to get in the ring, start throwing some punches?
Let's try.
Fabulous. Thank you so much. So Toastmaster Ram, take a deep breath, put on your table topics hat, because here comes your topic. The internet is a useful tool if it is used usefully. The internet is a useful tool if it is used usefully. Toastmaster Ram Tamang.
Thank you, Kandeshir. I totally agree. Internet is very useful if you use it fully. Nowadays, all the human beings without internet cannot live. Especially nowadays, when we have a COVID-19 around the world, whole world depending with internet. So new generation, they're almost like addict to the internet. But it is very useful if you use usefully to the basic life. For your study, Zoom meetings. So what I say, if people should not misuse the internet, especially for children, parents should be guidance for your kids, what they are doing, how they are using the internet, Zoom class. You are observing them, they are doing proper class to through the internet, they are gaining something through the internet, Googling well the proper site, not going to the wrong site. So all parents should observe, to guide their kids and use the proper way. Thank you. Back to you.
Thank you very much for that wonderful commentary. And let's get on to a little bit of a debrief. So you did use the PEP model and you mentioned right from the outset what your position was. You gave us the reasons why you felt that way and that formed the majority of your speech. As always, a quote, a story, an anecdote, a snippet from a song, a sight from the car when you are going along, something that personalizes this story particularly to you, and then a powerful summary. Repeat your position and say, this is why I say. What you did really well was your voice carried with a great amount of charity, and that confidence level did not drop across the board at any time in your presentation. Now, any guesses what you could have done better? You were John Cena. We couldn't see you. So in this example, if you are coming, it would be really nice if you could, we could have seen your handsome face. I'm sure that there may be a reason for it, but opportunities come rarely. Next time, I hope we can see you. Now, this is where my blood pressure starts to go up. We need to pick a third commentator. We are 50% down. We've got only two more topics left. Do we have Toastmaster Jansi in the house? Going once, going twice, going three times. Let's move on to the next speaker. Do we have Toastmaster Jisha Oman in the house?
Yes, I guess. Yes.
Is Toastmaster Jisha willing to give us the benefit of her wisdom?
Yes, I would like to take this.
Awesome. Fantastic. Toastmaster Jisha, take a deep breath. Put on your table topics hat, for here comes your topic. The person who is a friend to many is an enemy to themselves. The person who is a friend to many is an enemy to themselves. Toastmaster Jisha.
The person who is a friend to many, an enemy to themselves. I clearly agree with this. The reason is, if we are trying to be a friend to many people who are around, naturally, we will step back in that instance where we have to say a no. We have to be clearly agreeable to many situations. Maybe our mind should be saying a clear no. So in this situation, we try to maintain the friendship, whereas we question the integrity within ourselves. So over here, when I move ahead, maybe to collect one or two anecdotes, we can even think about our own past life, where many friends would have suggested to take up some of the instances which may not be interesting, but still we have gone for it just to make our friend happy. So this clearly shows, though we don't like, we went for it just to make them happy, which is not absolutely successful from our side. So I would suggest again, for sure, we should go ahead with that kind of scenarios too, where we learn to say a no. That means we are satisfying a part of ourselves. So on that note, I conclude my speech. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Jisha. Fantastically well done. Now, this topic is a tricky one because the topic is tricky. The topic is a polarizing topic. But the reason I picked it is because it is applicable almost every single day of our lives. Because every time we've got to make decisions based on our relationships. Thank you for attempting that topic. You did use the PREP model. You ran through the first three gears. You mentioned your position. You clearly mentioned the reason why you feel that way. And then you attempted to garner together a story. And at that point, this is where that particular topic gets really, really special. I'm sure something happened today where you had to sacrifice time, money, effort, energy to make a choice between a person and your personal benefit. Now, why is this topic controversial? Because it asks you to choose between people and options. So it's a controversial topic. You chose to go against the topic, respect, and you attempted to garner a nice story and you concluded powerfully as well. What you did really well was you came out and you picked the unpopular option. You didn't say, no, people are really important. You did say, for people to become important, I need to be important first. I need to take care of myself first. That came across convincingly with conviction. You did try to garner a story together. That's great. 50% of the job done. Make it personal. Give us names. Give us places. Give us a little bit of a description. For example, at work today, I was asked to go for lunch with my colleagues. But then I am already trying to control my diet because I want to live a healthy lifestyle today. So if you are able to concoct that sort of tiny mini vignette, mini anecdote, the story becomes relatable and it becomes believable. Final table topics speaker for today, and I cannot do this presentation without calling upon the man who is responsible for me being on this stage today, DTM Khalid. Shall we show them how it is done?
I have nothing to do with this. I'm sure you're calling Khalid Jalal.
Yes, I will call you on Thursday. Because I'm the table topics master on Thursday. Yeah, so I will call you on Thursday.
Okay.
Because there is Khalid Jalal, Khalid Ismail, Khalid Amin, and Khalid Abdullah. So this time it is for Khalid Jalal, the Division C director.
By default, whenever we say DTM Khalid, by default it goes to DTM Khalid Abdullah. And he, in his presence, I will really recommend that you'll pick him.
I will pick him on Thursday. I have already, it's there in my agenda. I've already, because I'm table topics master for a meeting on Thursday, he's already on the list.
Shoot.
DTM Khalid. Shoot. Take a deep breath. Put on your table topics hat. Because here comes your topic. The unprepared speaker has the right to be afraid. The unprepared speaker has the right to be afraid. Distinguished Toastmaster Khalid Jalal.
So, table topic master and fellow Toastmasters and guests, can anyone disagree with this beautiful quote from Dr. R.C. Smedley? I see a thumbs up, but no one is saying no. This is a quote which applies to every individual who is asked to come and speak, and he's not prepared. And I'm not unique. I'm one of those millions of people when they're asked to come on stage to speak, shiver. To fight my shivering in public speaking, and in a small gatherings even, I decided to join Toastmasters. When I joined Toastmasters, I thought this is going to give me some kind of a practice to speak. But when I heard this particular quote, I realized what is the core reason of me being afraid of public speaking. Or speaking in front of my management, speaking in front of a large gathering or in a function, not being prepared. This beautiful platform we call Toastmasters, and this particular quote from Dr. R.C. Smedley made me think and practice of speaking in any forum, no matter what, no matter how, no matter who's in front of me, but take the opportunity to speak just like I'm doing today when I'm called upon, surprisingly. So this is the reason I have built the courage to come forward and speak. I may be right, I may be wrong, I don't care about it, but as long as I'm building the courage within me and talking the truth, talking the right thing, passing the correct message, positive messages, I'm happy. This is why I cannot disagree with this statement at all. Back to you, Table Topic Master.
Thank you so much, DTM Khalid. Thank you very much for that insightful table topics commentary. Now, in the analysis of this speech, was DTM Khalid's position very clear? Right throughout these 2 minutes, he mentioned, I cannot disagree with this topic. A very unique statement to mention his position. He gave the reason why. And he said that this was my weakness. And he shared a personal story. He said, I wanted to share my thoughts with the management. And Toastmasters gave me that key to unlock that capability. And then he said very clearly, I'm sure that I cannot agree with it. Now, what I really like about this was the opening to this table topic. DTM Khalid asked a question, can anyone disagree? And then he didn't rush on like an express train. No, he paused, allowing even the virtual audience a chance to at least mentally respond to him. And then he showed us that he's aware of the audience by saying that someone had a thumbs up. That's very well done. Why is it well done? Because it creates a connection. It shows that the speaker is connected to the audience, even though we are electronic miles away on this electronic stage. What could be done better? Not much, but that conclusion, that final punch, could have been a little bit more fire. Practice makes perfect. And I'm sure the next time we see DTM Khalid, he will throw so many punches, we will not be able to stand. And we had time for four commentators. Please unmute your microphones and give them a big physical round of applause, because I'm sure that we all need it. Ladies and gentlemen, we are coming to the end of our small workshop. And I must quote, life is 10% about what happens to you and 90% how you respond. To paraphrase it to table topics, life is 10% about the questions you are asked, but it is 90% how you respond. You don't react to these questions, you respond to these questions. You have a moment now to answer one very important question, and you are at that crossroads right now. And that question is, how do you choose to respond? That is the secret to taking the terror permanently out of table topics. Thank you. Thank you for having me. Good luck. Best of luck to you. Back to you, Mr. T. Modi.
Wow. Mashallah. Thank you. Thank you very much, DTM Hisham. I told everyone over here that you will enjoy his session as we enjoyed Toastmaster.